These right here on the right hand side are early tomato plants. Those will be going in the high tunnels probably in about 2 weeks. It'll stay warm enough in there for them. There's onions, there's petunias, there's lots of greens.
If Abby Wiggin had her way, plants would already be in the ground at Wake Robin Farm, but...
Last year we planted peas on March 21st. You know, it's April 2nd now, and I can't get a tiller out in the field.
The reason?
The cold. Normally it warms up far before now, and it's just the cold and the rain. It's taking forever for the snow to go away.
It's the same in fields across the state, some farms 2 to 3 weeks behind schedule. Home gardeners and the gardening retail business slow to start, too.
As far as people coming in to shop, we're 2 weeks behind.
At Rolling Green Nursery, the winter blankets covering outdoor perennials are just now being rolled up, a week or two later than normal.
But see, there's a little activity here. There's somebody coming up there.
The greenhouse plants are on track, though the extra cold nights and lack of sunshine have slowed some a bit. The sense is that after this long cold winter, there's a pent-up demand to see color and eat fresh produce.
If you farm in New England, you kind of just have to take it in stride. Some years are going to be colder than others. I mean, I'm not worried by any means. It's just going to be late.
Experts say a few warmer than normal weeks could make a big difference. In Stratham, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.